Dear friends, this is Srinivasan, who is having more than 40 years experience in the construction industry, trying to present you a small presentation on the interview questions for a freshers and a junior engineers. In my 40 years of experiences, I have attended lot of interviews, and as well as I had a privilege of conducting interviews for the organization where I used to work for. In this period, I had collected a crucial 300 questions which has been asked in various interviews, which I listed in my earlier presentation also. In my earlier 4 presentations, I given you a list of around about 250 questions. This is my last bunch of 50 questions. This is my final set of the presentation on this subject. This set of a question is prepared on my experiences. An interviewer may ask different questions according to the situation. Best of luck for your interview and best of luck for your future endeavor. It's a civil conclave. Commonly asked interview questions. What is meant by a civil engineering? A civil engineering is a professional engineering discipline that deals with the design, construction, and maintenance of the physical and naturally built environment, including works like roads, bridges, canals, dams, and buildings. Civil engineering is arguably the oldest engineering discipline. It deals with built environment and can be dated for the first time someone placed around over his head or laid a tree trunk across a river to make it easier to get across. What does a civil engineering do? They do many interesting things. Their job has to do a lot with the design and construction. They can tell you what works and what will not work in all sort of situation. There is a lot of mathematics along with many other disciplines. They have to have a good solid understanding on how the environment works and how the nature interacts with the man-made. They are probably best known for designing bridges, interstates, skyscrapers, canals, and so forth. What are the functions of the column in the building? A column used to support the weight of the roof and or the upper floors. What are the causes of the building collapses? The passage of time is the one reason. Building also collapses due to weak foundations, earthquakes, hurricanes, and other natural disaster. Demolition also a part of other reasons. Describe briefly various methods of a concrete curing. Curing is the process of maintaining the moisture and temperature condition for freshly deployed concrete. This is done for a small duration of time to allow the hardening of the concrete. The methods are involved as follows. Spraying of water on walls and columns can be cured by sprinkling water. Wet covering of surfaces can be cured by using the surface with a gunny bags or a straw. Ponding. The horizontal surfaces including the slabs and floors can be cured by stagnating the water. Steam curing. Prefabricated concrete units steam can be cured by passing it over the units that are under closed chambers. It allows faster curing process and results are faster recovery. Application of curing compounds. Compounds having calcium chloride can be applied on curing surfaces. This keeps the surface wet for a very long time. Why is popping is required for a long structure once the formwork is removed? Once the formwork process of concreting is performed, the striking of the formwork should be done as soon as possible, as delay in the process can lead the discoloration of the concreting structure. In case of a long structure, particularly long span structure, once the structures have attained enough strength to support themselves, it is essentially to provide them with a popping as a creep deflection can take place, which can greatly reduce the integrity of the structure. Due to the above monitor reason, popping should be done after the removal of the formwork. Also, the pop should not be made to stand long as it can load the overstress for the structure. List out the potential risk factors of the workers at the construction site. They are fall from the heights, scaffold and trench collapse, electrical shocks, repetitive motion injuries, not using personal protective equipments correctly. What are the different type of foundations? They are basement. In this basement is prepared first on top of the building it is constructed. Crawl space. A crawl space is a raised foundation. It is built above the ground, just allowing enough space to crawl underneath. Slab. In this foundation, concreting is directly poured into the pit made on the ground. Explain what are the phases of inspection to be done by the local authority while construction. Site inspection, pre-construction or post-construction inspection, foundation inspection, framing inspection, insulation inspection, final inspection. List out some of the checkings done on the completion of the construction. Utility connections, drainages, retaining walls, compaction of the filled materials, caulking at opening, storm sewer system, safety provision, accessory building, pavement edging, protection against moisture penetration, design of the swelling structure. What does the construction cost covers and what it not covers? Construction cost covers material, labor, equipment, services, contractors overhead, profit and other direct construction cost. While it does not cover the compensation paid to the architect, consultant, engineers, cost of the land, another cost that is the owner responsibility. What is ductility? Ductility is the ability to deform under tensile stress. What is the difference between one-way and two-way slab? One-way slab, ratio of a longer span divided by shorter span greater than 2. Two-way slab, ratio of the longer span divided by shorter span is less than 2. What is the slope of a staircase? As per 456, the slope or a pitch of a stair should be between 25 degrees to 40 degrees. What is the crank length of the slab? The crank length of the slab is 0.42D, where D is the depth of the slab minus top cover minus bottom cover. What do you mean by a segregation? Segregation is a separation of the cement, sand from aggregate. This is caused due to water cement ratio and when the concreting is poured more than 1.5 meter. What is durability? Ability to withstand under pressure is called durability. What are the concrete tests? Slump test, concrete compressive strength test, water permeability test, water absorption test. When we go for a pile foundation is adopted when the soil bearing capacity is less than 24 kilonewton per cubic meter. What is the function of the stirrups in the column? Stirrups are provided to handle the shear force and to hold the rebars, that is the main bars, in position. What are the different types of civil engineering? Construction engineering, coastal engineering, civil engineering systems, environmental engineering, geotechnical engineering, surveying, water resources engineering, structural engineering, earthquake engineering, forensic engineering, urban or municipal engineering, transport engineering, material science and engineering. What is the crank length of the slab? minimum crank length of the slab is 300 mm. The formula of crank length is equal to D1 plus D2 plus 5 into 10 mm, where D1 is what the crank length of the slab. Minimum length of the crank is 300 mm. The formula of crank length is D1 plus D2 plus 5 into 10 mm, where D1 is the diameter of the smaller bar and D2 is the diameter of the largest bar. Diameter of the smaller bar and D2 is the diameter of the large. How to differentiate the volumes of wet and dry sand soil? It should be find out rapid moisture meter method, moisture correction method. In wet sand, moisture become more and in dry, moisture become less. In sand, moisture should be allowing only 12 to 25%. Volume will be differ from the both. What is the fineness of the cement? Fineness of the cement is a property of the cement that indicates particle size of the cement and specific surface area. Indirectly affect heat of hydration. If fineness is more, then the heat of dehydration will be more. To calculate fineness of the cement, saving are done. CO number size 9 and size of the CO is 90 micron. What is a VDF? VDF is a vacuum dewatered concreting. It is a system of laying high quality concrete floors with superior cost effectiveness. It is mainly used in industrial structures. How much of the strength of the concrete comes from post-production curing? After 28 days, it should be 99%. In 1 day, it should gain a 16%, 3 days, 40%, 7 days, 65%, 21 days, 90%, 28 is 99%. Under processing and only after 28 days, and we need to check for the target mean strength which is necessary. What is the minimum length of the wall after which expansion joints has to be provided? According to IS, for RC structures 45 meter, load bearing brick structures 30 meter, boundary wall 10 meter, overhanging members or fascia etc. 6 meter. According to you, what is the one important quality a civil engineer should possess? Civil engineer should have a bunch of important qualities to ensure strong career path. However, according to me, the most important quality which engineer should possess is strong critical thinking and sound technical knowledge. Why? What do you understand by segregation? Segregation is defined as a process of filtering cement and sand separately from the concrete mixture. In other words, segregation is caused due to vibration between materials forming a concrete. One material being high in weight and one being less tend to be uneven while in liquid state. The heavier material gets settled at the bottom of the concrete and the lighter material shall be at the top. What are the difference between concreting and the mortar? Concreting, it is a mixture of sand, cement, sand aggregate proper ratio with the water. It is a structure material component used for establishment of concreting slabs, columns, etc. In mortar, even though it is a building material collected of cement and the well sand with the water. Mortar work is a glue in between the bricks used to make a strong bond between the bricks. What is a beam? A beam is a very important element or the horizontal element of a structure is known as a beam, and the beams always keeps loads of action. Kindly tell me about the types of the load. Dead load. It is a permanent compound of the building like beam, column, slab, etc. This is known as self load. And also the furnitures and everything has to be loaded in the house, also called as a dead load, live load. In this all moving structure, like a person is moving on the floor which is not stable at a place known as a live load. Wind load. In this load, which is caused by the speed of the wind and its effect the tallest building. Snow load. It is generally considered in the wet snow areas. What is this tensile strength? It is the maximum longitudinal stress that an object can withstand without making. It denotes the maximum point in a stress or a strain curve. What are the building codes? Building codes are a set of specifications regarding minimum safety condition that any building should take into account during construction. Building codes deal with the height, spacing, insulation of the building. These codes lay huge emphasis on the safety and case to evacuate the building in case of an emergency. What are the basic admixture used for a concreting? Accelerator to shorten the setting time. Example, calcium chloride. Retarder to delay the setting time. Example, carbohydrate derivatives. What is the water cement ratio and how it is related to strength of the concrete? The water cement ratio is the ratio of the weight of the water with the weight of the cement used in the concreting mix. A lower ratio lead to higher strength and durability, but it may not be having the workability. For workability, you have to add on plasticizers, admixtures to increase the workability without adding additional water. What is meant by one-way slab? One-way slab is supported by beams only in two sides. The ratio of the longer span panel to shorter span panel is equal or greater than 2. Thus, L divided by greater than 2.3. Main reinforcement is provided in only one direction for one-way slabs. What is the use of pile foundation? Pile foundation system foundations relying on driven piles often have groups of piles connected by a pile cap to distribute loads which are larger than one pile can bear. What is the use of the plinth beam? You can see the beam is constructed at a ground level. The void between the foundation and the plinth level is filled with a compacted soil. Brick or stone masonry also constructed below the plinth. The plinth beam need to be strong but need not to be in a reinforced concreting at all times. What is the span in civil engineering? Span is the distance between two intermediate supports for a structure. Example, beam or a bridge. A span can be closed by a solid beam or by a rope. The first kind used for bridges, the second one for a power lines or a telecommunication line, some types of antennas or for aerial tramways. What is a beam and column? If you keep horizontally, it is called a beam, which is carries the loads by bending, simply called a flexural string. If you keep it vertically, it's known as a column, which is carries a load by undergoing compression. If you keep an inclined fashion, it is called a strut, which carries horizontal and vertical components of the forces. How deep the shooting should be? The projection of the footing on either side of the wall is supposed to be no greater than the depth of the booting. The bottom of the footing should be at least 12 inches below the finished grade line. It may need to be deeper. It must be below the frost line. What is the slump value of the concrete? For a dry mixer having slump of 0 to 25 mm are used in road making. Low workability mixers having slump to 10 to 40 are used for foundation with higher reinforcement. Medium workability 15 to 90 for a nominal reinforced concreting placed with a higher vibration. Higher workability concreting is greater than 100 mm. What is the bearing capacity? The supporting power of the soil is called as a bearing capacity. What is the curing concreting and why it is necessary? To prevent a lot of moisture from the concreting, we need to cure the concreting to keep the moisture in concreting for the hydration of cement to strengthen the concreting. Curing method, water curing method, membrane curing method and steam curing methods. What are the main factors affecting the mixed designs? Workability, durability and the economy. Give reasons of the cracks in the concreting. Bleeding, steel mesh on the surfaces or excess heating. What is the mean of the column? It is the vertical element of a structure. It's known. What is the different test in aggregate? Coarse aggregate, grading, content of clay lumps, soft fragments, sodium or magnesium sulfide soundness, loss engineer aberration, aggregate crushing value, impact value, flakiness and elongation index, chloride and sulfate content. Fine aggregate, grading, content of clay lumps, content of organic impurities, sodium or magnesium. What are the tolerance of different concreting structure? For all buried concreting, plus 25 millimeter, minus 12 millimeter. For soffit edges of the beam and sides of a parapet plinth is 3 mm. For all other concreting, 6 mm. What is the function of admixture or a retarder? To delay the setting time of a concrete and increase the concreting strength. What is the type of admixture used in concrete? Plasticizer, retarder, accelerator, plasticizer with a retarding agent, plasticizer with accelerating agents and so on. What is the function of the retarder admixture in concreting? To delay the setting time of a concreting to 1 to 4 hours over normal setting time and reduce the mixing water by about to 3.9 kgs per cubic meter, increase the compressive strength about 10 to 15%. Number two, reducing time to 1 to 4 hours to increase the strength 10 to 15% to decrease the mix water 3 to 9 during kbm³. What is the role of a civil engineer? Civil engineer involves in planning, design, construction, operation, etc. What is a shop drawing? What do you check on that? A detailed construction drawing that shows the proposed material, shape, size is called shape drawings. What is FDIC? The International Federation of Consulting Engineering is an international standard organization for the construction industries is called FDIC. What is the program of work? Program of work is a schedule. That is a basic timeline of how work will be complete. This schedule shows the work start and completion date and handing over the finished work. How will you calculate the rate analysis for 1 cubic meter of reinforced concreting? Estimate of material. Concreting is 1.1 cubic meter. Mixed design 1:1.53. Dry volume should be 1.54 times. The wet volume of the concrete. Dry concreting is equal to 1:1.54, that is a 1.54 cubic meter of a concreting. Bag of cement is required. 1:1.54 divided by 1 plus 1.5 plus 3, that is 0.28 cubic meter. Number of a bags, one cement bag volume is 3.347 cubic meter. So 0.8828 divided by 0.0347 is equal to 8.07 bags of cement. Volume of sand required, 1.5 × 1.54 divided by 1 plus 1.5 × 3, that is a 0.42 cubic meter of sand. Volume of coarse aggregate required, 0.84 MCube of course. Thank you for watching this presentation. Kindly subscribe and like, which will motivate me for a further good presentation. In case of any queries, do not hesitate to write to me. The response shall be at the earliest. Contact me, civilconclave@gmail.com or at my Telegram group, Ask Srini Telegram group. The link has been shown below. Please note, I have presented more than 65 presentations in the Civil Conclave YouTube channel, which will give you an idea of the construction. Kindly go through this presentation, which will make you stronger in attending the interviews. Thank you for watching. Kindly subscribe, like and share. Please